The show's over. Good night.
You're not Sammy before.
He wasn't being honest. Shame on you. You do agree with what your mother is talking about, don't you? I mean, what?
I think it sucks, but yeah, I don't understand it. Sure, y'all's house.
Him not say no for parents. Him say yes, of course. Him need the rights of his parents. Say, I think we need like this because my life, I'm not young boy, and this is my new wife, and this is life. Just until you get married, we feel it's just a respect thing.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Digging a tunnel.
We go married.
Go again.
We go married tomorrow. We don't have a problem if you marry.
Yes, no, I don't have a problem if you marry. I don't have a problem.
Can we also have children then?
Speaking of children, you guys do not want children right away, right?
Yes, we're not thinking about children now.
Okay. So you're going to take proper steps to make sure that there are no children yet?
We don't plan children now. We plan maybe after 2 years, 3 years.
But, I mean, you're making sure you have adequate protection
for Brandon. This is my life and him life. It's not life for parents. I don't like when people ask me these questions. Not comfortable for me. This is crazy. I'm not drinking medicine because when I go to the doctor says not good for all girls.
Drink medicine?
Yes.
That sounds like something out of the dark ages.
When she says drink medicine, she means like take medicine.
No. Things aren't like that anymore, though. There's an accident.
No, I'm 26 years. I never have accident about children. I live with ex-boyfriend. And
It's not 26 years. It's only a few years, and things happen when you don't plan them.
If we want children, we have children. Now we don't want.
Let's try and make sure you find a way to prevent that.
I feel not comfortable. I not talk with my parents about this. Why you talk with him parents? I don't want to go to doctor. I don't want to take medicine. And this is crazy. This is stupid. This is make me explode.
Make sure we find a way for you to go with me maybe to my doctor and talk about options.
I had no idea I was going to do this. It was totally unexpected. But I'm also like a little silently angry. I feel like even if I say something, it's not going to make a difference, so I might as well just not say anything.
Stop drinking.
I am looking for a gaming system. For my fiancé, he's 28. Oh, wow. There are regularly times I stop and think, what the hell am I doing? It's cute, right?
One day, she was just 10 weeks pregnant. I don't know. I'm terrified.
It's not about you anymore, and it's not about him. It's about your daughter.
This baby is coming to ruin her life.
Unexpected returns next Sunday at 10 on TLC.
Hear you the story of one brave family who spent every penny they owned to conquer a crumbling old castle. Methinks they're a wee bit batty. Escape to the Chateau, all new, Saturday night at 8 on HGTV.
Wow, I'm in love.
We have 90 days to get married.
90-day journey, streaming January 4th on Discovery Plus. Learn more at discoveryplus.com.
Hey, Derek.
Hey, I'm almost there.
Some friendly competition.
That's my way to play.
If you thought you saw the last of double cheeseburger pizza, think again. Because it's back at Papa John's again. Get a large double cheeseburger pizza for just $12. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
Does your vitamin C last 24 hours? Only Nature's Bounty does. New Immune 24 Hour Plus has longer lasting vitamin C, plus herbal and other immune superstars. Only from Nature's Bounty.
We are the thrivers. Women with metastatic breast cancer, standing in the struggle, hustling through the hurt, asking for science, not sorries. Our time for more time has come. Living longer is possible and proven in women taking Kisqali plus fulvestrin or a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor. Kisqali is the only treatment in its class with proven overall survival results in 2 clinical trials, helping women live longer with HR-positive, HER2-negative metastatic breast cancer. Kisqali was also significantly more effective at delaying disease progression versus a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor or fulvestrin alone. Kisqali can cause lung problems or an abnormal heartbeat, which can lead to death. It can cause serious skin reactions, liver problems, and low white blood cell counts that may result in severe infections. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including breathing problems, cough, chest pain, a change in your heartbeat, dizziness, yellowing of the skin or eyes, dark urine, tiredness, loss of appetite, abdomen pain, bleeding, bruising, fever, chills, or other symptoms of an infection, a severe or worsening rash, are or plan to become pregnant or breastfeeding. Avoid grapefruit during treatment. Kisqali is not approved for use with tamoxifen. It's our time to continue to shine because we are the thrivers. Ask your doctor about Kisqali, the only treatment in its class proven to help women live longer in 2 clinical trials.
I love him so much.
I miss being able to be close to him.
We never really kissed when we lived together, but I still really want that first kiss.
All new Welcome to Plathville, Tuesday at 10 on TLC. Tomorrow.
We want to be a part of your most important day of your life.
Do not cause any problems.
I don't trust our royals and family. They're unpredictable.
Fanny Chantel, season finale. Tomorrow at 9 on TLC.
Tomorrow is a big day because Ziad finally has his visa interview in Tunisia. I think the reality of it maybe is kind of setting in, and I'm hearing a little bit more pushback from my family and friends, but I'm still excited, and even though his visa has not been approved yet, I am so hopeful that he will be that I'm already prepping for his arrival. To get a work permit for 6 months. So yeah, he had mentioned that he wanted a video game console because he's going to be stuck at home and needing something to do while I'm working. You'll have to help me. I have literally no idea what I'm looking for. I'm thinking that I'll get maybe a soccer game or something, but I'm hoping that the staff can kind of help me and tell me what somebody his age might want to do. But what they want to play.
You said you don't really know what you're looking for?
No, I have no idea, really. My son is 25. I think the last time I bought one, he was 17, 18 years old, something like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So do you remember what your son likes to play?
Well, I mean, it's not for my son.
No?
Buying it for my fiancé. It's just,
they're close to the same age.
Yeah.
Might be a rude question, but how old is your fiance?
He'll be 28. My son is 25.
Oh, wow.
Anyway, I can help you for sure. It's like charming, you know, that she's trying to buy like this thing that she thinks her fiance would enjoy. So I think this would be good.
Can he hook up like a debit card to it and buy games and stuff?
Yeah.
Awesome.
But her fiance is around the same age as her son, and it kind of makes me wonder, like, is her son comfortable with the relationship?
Yeah, so it's gonna be 2-15-15. Very cool. Oh, who's this on the card?
That would be my fiance.
Oh, yours?
He's cute, right?
Yeah,
I get razzed a little bit by my kids because I have pictures of him everywhere.
Awesome.
Ziad and I are 21 years apart, and yes, there are regularly times where I stop and think, what the hell am I doing? It's never when I'm talking to him, but most people that I come across can't possibly understand the special bond that we share.
Here's your receipt. Appreciate you coming out tonight.
I hope he likes it.
It should be very fun.
I just hope that when Ziad arrives, the judgment from the outside world doesn't come between us in any way.
Oh my gosh.
It is 2 a.m. now, but it's morning in Tunisia, and Ziad is on his way to the interview right now. Yeah, we're pretty nervous. I'm really tired, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to sleep. We'll see. I'm not sure. At this point, Ziad's paperwork is approved, and this interview is the last thing standing between his life here with me and America. So everything is hinging right now on the next couple of hours. He just has to prove to the interviewer that he's not in this just for a green card and that he really loves me. I think I want to send him a quick little good luck message. Baby, please be safe driving, and please call me as soon as you know something. And send me a message when you get to the embassy so I know you get there safe. And good luck, baby. It's going to be okay no matter what. I love you. I know how stressed out he is. And I'm concerned about his little heart. It breaks my heart to think of him sitting in there being scared and being by himself. And I just want to be able to be there with him and hold his hand and, you know, make him feel comfortable. I'm just hoping in the next hour, 2 hours maybe, that he says that it's approved and then he'll be here to sleep with me. I'll see you soon, baby.
I started talking online, you know, to this girl. After Hazel and I had broken up, I met Minty. She's really pretty. I'm afraid to tell Hazel. I'm worried that it might mess everything up.
Dr. Pimple Popper pops over to Monday. I'm so excited to see you.
Bigger.
That's the most giant pilot cyst I've ever seen.
And wetter than ever. Dr. Pimple Popper pops over to Mondays, December 28th at 9 on TLC.
Oh, hey, you. Want to live like a millionaire? I can show you how on an all-new season of My Laundry Dream Home on HGTV. All-new My Laundry Dream Home, Friday night at 8 on HGTV.
Let's deck the halls over video calls with sweatpants, houseplants, and a 3 p.m. happy dance with pizza buying and reindeer flying and just a little joyful cry with all your family and all your friends. First bites and happy ends. It's all essential in every way. And together, it makes a holiday. Let's end the year with what matters.
Are we turning our cameras on for this?
My smile can't compete.
Have you one?
Nope. For a smile that's always camera ready, Crest 3D White removes 95% of stains